such a damsel in distress?
They were all dead. Love kills. Did I love her? Was there a choice? The past is a gaping hole. You try to run from it. The more you run, the deeper, more terrible it grows behind you. Its edges yawning at your heels. Your only chance is to turn around and face it.
We are at the sea. Repeat, we are at the sea.
But it's like looking down into the grave of your love.
Check the area. Hold your fire.
Or kissing the mouth of a gun, a bullet trembling in its dark nest, ready to blow your head off.
We're losing him.
Multiple gunshot wounds. Pupils blown, head trauma, God only knows what
else. He's been shot. Start 2 large bore IVs, get him to ICU.
He's not responding. This guy is a train wreck. We're losing him.
When I woke up in the hospital earlier tonight, I thought it couldn't get any worse. I opened my eyes, and everything slid into focus. She was dead. I was hurt. My crime, what I had done, was like a hungry pit behind me. I had to run, get as far away from it as possible. The world was out of joint. I was hallucinating. I had to get away.
Max.
Allow me to present MaxPayne3.
Come on up.
Max. Dear, my friend.
Payne.
It's yours.
You're in the middle.
Max. 911.
Sorry, I'm
okay. Run! Run!
Max, what's going on?
Anyone there?
I would fuck her.
Max Payne!
What are you so afraid of? What do you want from me?
There was a blind spot in my head. A bullet-shaped hole where the answer should be. I wanted to dig inside my scrape out the pain.
He's as good as dead.
Freeze, NYPD!
Found him!
She's here to kill me.
Back off, Payne.
Winterson!
setting on a sweet summer day, rain sparkling on grass. Children playing. Mental Institute.
You're not going anywhere. What happened out there? You did it. Eternal Affairs is breathing down my neck. Did you do it? You killed her.
No, I can't.
Oh, bullshit!
My fault. You can't run from your past. You'll end up running in circles. Until you fall back down to the same hole you were trying to escape from. Only the hole's grown deeper. I had tried to run from it, edit it out. Winterson was dead. I was a murderer. I wanted to be punished for what I had done, but Alfred Woden had kept his word. With his influence, ridiculously, I had emerged from my history of violence unscathed, a hero. I didn't thank him. I couldn't stomach it. I left the DEA. I went back to where I had started out, back to the job, the NYPD.
Reported shots fired in the warehouse there, acknowledged.
It's mine. I'm on it.
10-4.
It wasn't a call for a homicide detective, but I knew the address. The warehouse belonged to Vladimir Lem. He was connected to organized crime. We went back a while, like brothers caught on opposite sides in a civil war. His words. I need backup. Unknown number of armed perps inside. Possible hostage situation.
10-4, backup is on its way.
I'm going in. With no way to deal with view mirror in the road, I chase lesser mysteries, other
in the dark and violent night.
Dick Justice, a lone, hard-boiled fugitive cop, framed for the murder of his wife, on a quest for vengeance through the criminal underworld in the city's heart of darkness. The rain was coming down like all the angels in heaven had decided to take a piss at the same time. In a situation like mine, you can only think in metaphors. They had killed the love of my life. They were going to pay.
NYPD!
Whoa, easy, officer, easy. Just cleaning the place. Come on, officer, it's all legit. I work for the squeaky cleaning company.
You didn't hear anything suspicious just now?
No, no. Oh, wait! You mean the gun workshop upstairs.
Take me there. Move.
Sure. That's what you want. You know, officer, you cops got it easy. Go to the crime scene and look around a bit. We're the ones who have to clean up that mess, brains, and guts and shit.
Detective.
DT, huh? You know what I mean. You get the credit, what do we get?
Right.
Oh, yeah. You know what I'm saying. A cop! Get in here! Get him!
Perps were masquerading as cleaners.
Sure, the cleanup's done. Body, blood, prints, air, mags, empty brass. When we're out of here, there won't be a shred of... You're done for!
The room looked like gun storage, but it had been cleaned out. The answering machine had a message on it.
Enough chit-chat. Finish her!
Wait! The mob guys attacked us! I have no beef with you guys! You took them out! Listen, I work for Vladimir!
Honey, you work for no one.
What do you want? We can...
NYPD, drop them!
Finish her!
Oh, God, no!
This off.
Hoffman wants us to move.
Stop him! Coward!
Come on! Finally.
Hey!
Mona?
Max, we gotta stop meeting like this.
Mona!
If you think nothing can get to you, you're lying to yourself. At best, you're temporarily dead. A lightning bolt can reanimate you without a warning. My backup had arrived, but the cleaners were slipping away, making a run for it.
all right.
I'm okay, damn it.
Hey, we're working together on this.
You got sloppy, Payne. You screwed up. It's unacceptable that she's dead. You can do better.
I played.
You got sloppy, Payne.
I needed to talk to Vlad, get his version. Be the bearer of bad news on Annie Finn. Vlad had bought the old Ragnarok nightclub. He was renovating it into a trendy restaurant, Vodka. Mona's appearance had triggered a dislocation, schizophrenia. I felt elation, but with it, fear that all the past evils had come along for the ride.
Vlad! Max! 911! Bad guys with big guns! They've got me pinned down at the entrance hall! Could you some help? Could use it now!
I had to find another way to reach Vlad. No time to call backup. My case had a life of its own. I got in through the back door. Memories of my previous visit here lurked in the shadows. A musty smell under the coat of new paint.
Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to present MaxPayne. New York's finest, with the biggest mobster body count ever. Dearest guests, prepare to die. Max, I'd love to come and welcome you, but I'm busy dodging bullets and hiding under a desk at the moment.
You're MaxPayne.
Afraid so.
Max! I'm Mike, Vladimir's friend. You are the sheriff. How about making me your deputy?
Let's go bail out your boss before he talks us all to death.
Let's ride!
They asked for it. Just follow the trail.
Episode 165. Captain Baseball Bat Boy's girlfriend.
Yeah, she's not my girlfriend.
Got some
That's
heavy
more
shit
like
here.
It.
Bicycle Just Helmet Girl has been kidnapped by the villainous Maxwell
Be on the lookout.
Demon.
The Russians
Get
are sneaky bastards.
Me, ugly freak.
They're here.
Get them. Get them.
Winterson would have found a way to... Logic told me backup should be on its way. Someone must have heard the gunfire. Fire.
We'll get there. Up the stairs.
T, the whole set for a two. The only way to do it. Hey, Chip, one of ours, we go dental on him.
Hey, what can you do? Vinny's the boss. Half of the time, he's too busy playing with his toys.
Gun business is our business. Ours. I don't care who says otherwise. We're in the gun business.
Right. What can you...
Who's there?
Oh! Damn!
Ah! Shoot! Shoot! Ah!
Put it out! Put it out!
Vlad! Max! 911! Bad guys with big guns! They've got me pinned down at the entrance hall! Could use some help! Could use it now!
I had to find another way to reach Vlad. No time to call backup. My case had a life of its own. I got in through the back door. Memories of my previous visit here lurked in the shadows. A musty smell.